Good afternoon. Welcome here today before God in the presence of family and friends to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the work and duty of love, and to add those wishes and blessings to run the living and to shelter God as they become one in natural life. Let us pray. Listen to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, bless with your grace to serve the Brandon and Michelle, by coming together in matrimony, that may be confirmed in love for one another, to our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Before I read the scripture and a portion of the letter to the Corinthians, this is the ancient Greece.
You may be seated.
But first, let me give you a short background on why we were the people. You have informed that the people of the church planned together during one missionary trip. That there's a lot of people in disagreements and divisions. Of certain things, animosity towards each other, some are encouraging the sins, there are too many to mention. Things come to men, some are classes, they're very understanding towards the group. People, if Paul was living on this day and age, he would just have said text message a bit quicker. And here is Paul's prescription to this group of people, and I hope you can all identify it. If I could speak in any language in heaven or on earth, within love others, would be making a meaningless noise like a loud gong or clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy, and if I know all the mysteries of the future, knew everything about everything, but didn't love others, what would I be? And if I had the gifts of faith so that I could stick to a mountain and make it move, without love, I would be no good to anybody. If I gave everything to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it, but I didn't love others, I would be of no value whatsoever. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. Love does not demand its own way. Love is not irritable, and it keeps no record of when it has been wrong. It's never glad about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up. Never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. There are three things that endure: faith, hope, but the greatest of these is love. Let love be your highest goal. Some of you know that I love to do research and surveys, and tabulated score, and putting a post letter to application, you could get 100 points if you're the most talented, the most gifted, good looking, smart, you have all the riches and talent. If your top score is zero, according to Paul, that doesn't mean anything. That would be of no value. But if you flip the score, say, your score will be zero on a gifted, talented, you don't have so much riches, that will be zero. But if your love score is 100, our life and relationship will be more meaningful. Our community, our city, and our nation, and our world will be a better place to live. And grant and we share it to all of us. Let love be our God. May this word of the Lord be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path.
Rabbi and Mishael, both of you have traveled to life individually, being shaped by different circumstances that made who you are today. Finding each other was not a coincidence, it was a blessing. Your lives were moving each other as you share goals and dreams that can only be obtained through love. Today they become one in matrimony, but you're not entering this marriage alone. Within this union, you're God and yourself, surrounded by the love and support of your family and friends. The scripture reads that love is patient, kind, it reveals you with the truth, he bears your things, and your soul for you. Love has no limit. Love never fails. But it also foretells what happens in the absence of love. Without it, this to be without each other, like it's empty, meaningless, and it has no purpose. We are to continue to work together and be grateful to God for each other and for your blessings. A husband and wife have to understand that only love will maintain the marriage, and this love must be nurtured and cared for every day. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never meant to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It's never going to sleep anything. They stand together in faces of the world. It's speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forgive. It is giving each other an environment to grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It's not finding the right person, but being the right person for the other. Today, truth is one of the day in the Lord has come. Let us rest in here with both of you on the joy, happiness, and success as you travel through life together. Remember that love is what makes marriage the union that will last forever. This time I'd like to ask you, please move forward to that other union we can have. This light is the symbol of life that was given to you at birth. This is a sign of warmth, wisdom, unconditional love, and the strength of your family's fire. Now, as you light up the candle of unity, from your individual candles, you symbolize the flame of your own individual selves, joining to ignite the union of marriage. Becoming one fire, one heart, one mind. From the day forward, you bask in the beauty of the light of your love. Would you honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Please be the greatest moment.
Even with all my imperfections, you still accept me as I am. promise to support you during our difficulties, but also comfort you when you cry.
Also, I'll be patient and respect you, but also celebrate your success, laugh at you, and with you. And I also promise you can keep me in check whenever I gamble. But most of all, I promise to love you until the very end.
As we begin a new chapter in our lives, Amy has been alive. I recall all the special moments we shared, and I feel so honored and blessed to have you in my life. You truly are the best thing in my life. I want to say thank you for always taking care of me and just being there to support me through all of the trials and hardships. I vow to always give you the best version of myself. And I love you so much. I can't wait to spend the rest of my entire life with you. I love you.
My dear friend, as our God, please continue blessing upon this time. Lord, may the fruits of blessings come upon them. May they both praise you when they're happy and turn to you in your suffering. May they be glad that you help them in your work. May know that you are with them in their needs. May they pray to you and in your witnesses. May they come at last to the kingdom of heaven. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you and keep you well. Today we have declared your love for each other and have committed to your vows before God with his blessing in the company of your family and friends. Therefore, to consecrate your minister, you are fully invested in the needs of Texas, of your master's husband, and your wife. Therefore, we God has joined together, they will make us happy. We will kiss your father.
would like to give a lot of example to these for all the persons of the hour, the exit doors at the end. We move for that way. We have all of us in that process for you.
Thank you.